If you are watching this video, you may have watched the first two parts of this list of the top 20 applications of NLP for business. You will find the link in the description in case you missed it. Hello, everyone. I am Riccardo Osti, and I help the most successful companies to increase their profitability by investing in the consumer experience. Let's continue with number 11, duplicate detection. Many forums and Q&A such as Quora use duplicate detection technology to keep their site functioning at its best. For example, imagine you search for "Are fresh blueberries healthier than the frozen ones?" on Quora, and you see a whole list of similar questions that have been previously asked, including, as an example, "Are fresh blueberries healthy? Are frozen blueberries healthy? What is healthier between fresh or frozen blueberries? Is it better to consume fresh instead of frozen blueberries? Is buying fresh blueberries better?" and so on. Obviously, if you have to click on each question and review the answer for that question and make your way down to the entire list, this would take you a lot of time and energy. If all the questions have been collated into a single question or thread, on the other hand, this would make your life so much easier. Because of this, Quora uses NLP to reduce the instances of duplicate questions as much as possible. Once a user finishes typing their question, Quora then analyzes it to determine if it's linguistically similar to another question that's already up on their site, and then serves up a list of similar questions that users can just refer to, instead of posting a new question. Number 12, translation tools. If you're traveling to a place where English, or your native language, isn't commonly spoken or understood, then you'll definitely want to install a translation app on your phone. By far the most popular tool is Google Translate, which is used by about 500 million people every day to understand more than 100 different languages. Google Translate relies on NLP to understand phrases and terms that the users are trying to translate, and the same goes for all the other alternative translation apps that there are out there. Interesting applications of NLP for translations are producing the first version of voice-to-voice translation, which would eventually lead to seamless communication between people that are actually speaking a different language. Now, it's usually a text. Number 13, chatbots. With live chat, there is a chat agent on the other end of the line helping you answer your inquiries. But ever wonder how chatbots understand what it is that you're asking them and answer your questions? This boils down to NLP. Using NLP and machine learning, chatbots can decipher consumers' questions, recommend them products, book meetings or appointments, and more. Using chatbots is interesting, but also very risky. If you want to know why, you can watch my video on this matter. You will find it here and at the link in the description. Number 14. Upgraded chatbots. Standard issue chatbots are a dime of a dozen, but these days companies are increasingly building upgraded chatbots to supercharge their customer service efforts. No one wants to talk to a stupid bot, right? Take Mastercard's chatbot that was launched back in 2016. This chatbot functions as a virtual assistant, and it's almost as good as having a bank in your pocket. That's what they say. Among other things, the chatbot can give users high level of a view of their spending habits, highlight the special benefits and the promotions that you are entitled to, or more, something personalized. As regular chatbots, these upgraded bots utilize NLP to understand queries and also to formulate the answers. Number 15, bots for a knowledge base. Ever heard of self-serve knowledge bases? These knowledge bases are basically a portal or an online library full of information, including FAQs, troubleshooting guides, and more. By building knowledge bases, companies are empowering their customers to resolve their own problems 24/7 by themselves, instead of contacting the company's support department and having to actually wait for someone to talk to them. Because knowledge bases often contain thousands of documents, it's in the company's best interest to help their customers identify the right materials quickly. To do this, companies can link their chatbots up with their knowledge base and configure their bots to send customers the right links to the docs that they may think they are helpful for them. Subscribe to my channel by hitting the subscribe button. And also click the bell close to it, because you will receive a new mail or message every time I publish a new video. When do I post new videos? Simple, every Monday and Thursday. So stay tuned.